everybody, it's Patty, and today I'm going to read a story called Jamaica Tag Along. And if you have an older brother or older sister or younger brother or younger sister, you might see a lot of the things that you might feel the same about, how you feel about a brother or sister in this book. Okay, here we go. Jamaica ran to the kitchen to answer the phone, but her brother got there first. "It's for me," Ozzy said. Jamaica stayed and listened to him talk. "Sure," said Ozzy. "I'll meet you at the court." Ozzy got his basketball from the closet. "I'm going to shoot baskets with Buzz. Can I come?" said Jamaica. "I don't have anything to do." "Ah, Jamaica, call up your own friends." "But everybody's busy today. I don't want you tagging along." "I don't want to tag along," Jamaica said. "I just want to play basketball with you and Buzz." "You're not old enough. We want to play serious ball." Ozzy dribbled his basketball down the sidewalk. Jamaica followed at a distance on her bike. Buzz was already at the school court shooting baskets with Jed and Maurice. She parked her bike by the bushes and crept to the corner of the school building to watch. "That's not fair," Jamaica thought. "Maurice is shorter than I am." The boys started playing ball. Ozzy and Jed against Buzz and Maurice. Jamaica sneaked to the edge of the court. Maurice missed a shot and the ball came bouncing toward her. Jamaica jumped. "I've got the ball," she yelled. "Jamaica!" Ozzy was so surprised he tripped over Buzz. They both fell down. Jamaica dribbled to the basket and tossed the ball. It whirled around the rim and flew out. "I almost made it," Jamaica shouted. "Can I be on your team, Ozzy?" "No, N-O, Jamaica. I told you not to tag along. It's not fair. You let Maurice play." "Oh, we need two on a team. Why don't you go play on the swings and just get out of the way?" "I still don't think it's fair." Jamaica walked away slowly to the sandlot. She started to swing, but a little boy kept walking in front of her. "His mom should keep him out of the way," Jamaica thought. She looked up and saw a woman pushing a baby back and forth in a stroller. Jamaica sat down in the sandlot and began to dig. She made a big pile with her wet sand from underneath. She scooped the sand from the mounds to form a wall. "Berto help," said the little boy. He sprinkled dry sand on the walls. "Don't," said Jamaica. "You'll just mess it up." She piled the sand high. She made the castle with towers. She dug a ditch around the wall. Jamaica turned to see if Berto was still there. He stood watching. Then he tried to step over the ditch and his foot smashed the wall. "Stay away from my castle," Jamaica said. "Berto," the woman pushing the stroller said, "leave this girl alone. Big kids don't want to be bothered by little kids." "That's what my brother always says," said Jamaica. She thought. "But I don't like when my brother says it to me. It hurts my feelings." Jamaica smoothed the wall. "See, Berto, like that. You can help me make a bigger castle if you'd like. Just be careful." Jamaica and Berto made a giant castle. They put water from the drinking fountain around to make a moat. "Wow," Ozzy said when the game was over. "Do you need some help?"
"If you want to," Jamaica said.
Jamaica, Berto, and Ozzy worked together on the castle. Jamaica didn't even mind if Ozzy tagged along. That was a pretty good story, huh? Thanks. See you next time.